Hello friends, welcome to our YouTube channel Ishala. In our today's session, we will discuss current affairs for September 1st week 2017. For more questions, you can also download our mobile app India GK, where you will get many other current affairs questions, GK questions and free previous year's exam papers. So let's now see the current affairs questions for this week. Who is appointed as new secretary in Ministry of Finance? Correct answer, Rajiv Kumar. Rajiv Kumar on 1st September 2017 assumed office as the new secretary, Department of Financial Services, Ministry of Finance. Shri Rajiv Kumar was special secretary and establishment officer in Ministry of Personal Public Grievances and Pension, Department of Personnel and Training in his immediate preceding posting. Rajiv Kumar was widespread administrative experience in more than 30 years of service, during which he held various important assignments including administrative postings in his home state of Jharkhand. Who takes over as the new vice chairman of Niti Aayog on 1st September 2017? Correct answer, Dr. Rajiv Kumar. Dr. Rajiv Kumar has taken charge as the new vice chairman of Niti Aayog on 1st September. A renowned economist, he replaces Shri Arvind Panagariya as the head of the premier think tank of the country. Addressing a press conference in the capital after assuming his office, he said the priority would be to carry forward the spirit of the Team India for a better future, keeping in mind the aspiration of millions across the country. The new vice chairman said there would be more emphasis on improving government capacity at the state level to ensure the values of cooperative and competitive federalism. Who gets Rashtriya Khel Prosahan Puraskar 2017? Correct answer, Reliance Foundation. Reliance Foundation was rewarded with the prestigious Rashtriya Khel Prosahan Award at Rashtrapati Bhavan. Chairperson of the foundation, Nita Ambani, collected the award from President Ram Nath Kovind. For its contribution to the promotion of sports, the award went to Reliance Foundation. Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan also received the Rashtriya Khel Prosahan Puraskar for its identification and nurturing of budding and young talent program. Mahabaleshwar Sale gets Saraswati Samman 2016 for which novel? Correct answer, Hawthorne. Prominent Konkani writer Mahabaleshwar Sale was presented with the Saraswati Samman 2016 for his novel called Hawthorne. The novel Hawthorne, published in 2009, captures cultural lives of traditional potter community in Goa. He was awarded the Sahitya Academy Award in Konkani language for his short story collection Taranga in 1993. The award carries a cash prize of Rs. 15 lakh, a citation and a plaque of Goddess Saraswati. Who is the author of the book Godman to Tycoon? Correct answer, Priyanka Pathak Narayan. Godman to Tycoon, The Untold Story of Baba Ramdev is book by author Priyanka Pathak Narayan on Baba Ramdev's journey from yoga guru to founding a successful FMCG firm in Patanjali Ayurveda. Pathak Narayan won the CNN Young Journalist Award for her coverage of the Setu Samundram channel project in 2007 and covered the business of religion beat for Mint a solid 6 years. A Delhi court's interim injunction on sale of Godman to Tycoon was passed without representation from the publishers and author. Which city is hosting the 9th edition of BRICS Summit 2017? Correct answer, Xiamen. The 9th edition of BRICS Summit 2017 has started at Xiamen in the Fujian province of East China on September 3, 2017 with theme BRICS Together Partnership for a Brighter Future. For this, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has embarked on a two-nation tour of China and Myanmar. On the first leg of his visit, Mr. Modi will attend the 2017 BRICS Summit. In the three-day summit, at least four documents, BRICS Action Agenda on Economic and Trade Development, BRICS Action Agenda on the Innovation Cooperation, BRICS Customs Cooperation and an MOU between BRICS Business Council and New Development Bank are expected to be signed. Which country recently does underground nuclear test? Correct answer, North Korea. North Korea on 3rd September carried out its most powerful nuclear test to date, claiming to have developed an advanced hydrogen bomb that could sit atop an intercontinental ballistic missile. US Defense Secretary Jim Mattis spoke out after North Korea carried out an unexpectedly strong nuclear test set to exceed in power the 1945 atomic bombing of Hiroshima. UN Chief Antonio Guterres has condemned the underground nuclear test by North Korea, calling it an act that is profoundly de-establishing for regional security. President of India has appointed whom as India's first full-time woman defense minister. Correct answer, Nirmala Sitharaman. Nirmala Sitharaman, the former Minister of State for the Commerce and Industry Ministry, has become the new defense minister of India on September 3, 2017, after latest Union Cabinet reshuffle. She succeeded Arun Jaitley. With this, she has become the India's second woman defense minister after Indira Gandhi, while India's first full-time woman defense minister. Currently, she is Member of Parliament in Rajya Sabha representing the state of Karnataka. Now, Suresh Prabhu has become the new Union Minister of Commerce and Industry. Who has been appointed as the new Union Minister of Railways? Correct answer, Piyush Goyal. Piyush Goyal has been appointed as the new Union Minister of Railways after the latest Union Cabinet reshuffle on September 3, 2017. He succeeded Suresh Prabhu. Who has become the new Union Minister of Commerce and Industry? Prabhu resigned from the post after a series of train accidents in August 2017. Apart from railways, Piyush Goyal retains the Ministry of Coal. Along with Goyal, Dharmendra Pradhan, Nirmala Sitharaman and Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi were promoted to the cabinet rank. Who is first wicketkeeper to take 100 stumpings in ODI? Correct answer, MS Dhoni. Former India captain Mahendra Singh Dhoni became the first wicketkeeper in world cricket to effect 100 stumpings in one day international during the 5th ODI against Sri Lanka on 3rd September 2017. Dhoni achieved the feat in his 301st ODI when he whipped off the Wales to remove Akila Dhananjaya of leg spinner Yuzvendra Chahal's bowling. The 36-year-old has also taken 281 catches apart from scoring 9,657 runs. Dhoni has also played 90 tests and 77 T20 internationals. Which media group wins IPL broadcasting rights for next 5 years? Correct answer, Star India. Star India wins the broadcasting rights for IPL for the next 5 years on 4 September 2017 with a whopping bid of 16,347.50 crore rupees. BCCI CEO Rahul Johri has listed out the names eligible for the bids. For TV rights, Star and Sony Pictures Network are strong candidates, whereas for digital rights, Times Internet, Reliance Jio, Airtel and Facebook have emerged as contenders. The BCCI CEO Rahul Johri has said that the revenue generation from the upcoming IPL media rights auction could be historic considering the huge interest shown by various stakeholders. Which city became 9th Indian city to have metro rail system on 5th September 2017? Correct answer, Lucknow. Uttar Pradesh capital Lucknow became the 9th Indian city to have its own operational metro rail system after Lucknow Metro Rail Corporation LMRC first phase was flagged off by Union Home Minister Rajnath Singh and Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath on 5th September. The 8.5-kilometer long first phase from Transport Nagar to Charbagh comes under LMRC's priority corridor section. It will be operational for the public from 6 a.m. to 10 p.m. daily. It is worth mentioning that former Chief Minister Akhilesh Yadav and his father Mulayam Singh Yadav had flagged off the trial run on the same stretch in December 2016. 8 Indian cities having operational metro services are Kolkata, Delhi, Bengaluru, Gurugram, that is Gurgaon, Mumbai, Jaipur, Chennai and Kochi. RBI recently includes which bank in too big to fail list? Correct answer, HDFC Bank. RBI on 5th September included HDFC Bank in the list of too big to fail lenders referred to as DSIB or Domestic Systematically Important Bank. India's largest lender SBI and private sector major ICICI Bank were classified as DSIBs in 2015. With the inclusion of HDFC Bank in the list, there will now be three too-big-to-fail financial entities in the country. RBI had issued the framework for dealing with DSIBs in July 2014. As per the framework, RBI has to disclose the names of banks designated as DSIBs every year in August, starting from 2015, and place these banks in appropriate buckets depending upon their systematic importance scores. SIBs are seen as too big to fail, creating expectation of government support for them in times of financial distress. These banks also enjoy certain advantages in funding market. Thank you friends for watching our video. Hope you would like our effort. You can download our mobile app India GK for free sold old exam papers, daily current affairs, GK notes and other MCQs. Please also share this video with your friends and subscribe our YouTube channel Ishala. Thank you.